properties of roots of the equation. Ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. A and c have same sign. Then the roots also have same sign. Roots are positive means A and C have the same sign. And A and C are opposite signs. Then roots have opposite signs. But suppose take the roots like this. Alpha value is 2. And beta value minus 3. Form the quadratic equation. X square minus sum of the roots into x plus product of the roots 2 into minus 3. Calculate this. X square plus x minus 6 is equal to 0. So A value is 1, C value is minus 6. These two, observe that both are having opposite signs. One is positive, one is negative. By observing A and C value, both have same sign means the roots also same sign. A and C have opposite sign means the roots also opposite sign. Okay. Next, third one. If A is equal to C, A and C value same, then the roots are reciprocals to each other. Reciprocals to each other. But suppose alpha value is 2, then beta value is 1 by 2. Both the roots are reciprocals to each other. Form the quadratic equation. X square minus sum of the roots into x plus product of the roots is equal to 0. Now do the calculation. Take the LCM. You'll get 2x square minus 5x plus 2 is equal to 0. Here observe that A and C have same. A is equal to C. So then the roots are what? Reciprocals to each other. Next, both the roots are negative. Then A, B, C will have the same sign. Both the roots are negative means one of the root, take that 2. Both the roots are negative now. Alpha value is minus 2. Beta value is minus 3. By using these two roots, form the quadratic equation. Then you will get quadratic equation like this. X square 5x plus 6 is equal to 0. Then observe here, A value is 1, B value is 5, and C value is 6. So both the roots are negative, then A, B, C will have same sign. Okay? Both the roots are positive, A and C will have same sign, different from the sign B. But suppose see here, alpha and beta both are positive only. What we got? A value is 2, B value is minus 2, C value is 2. See here, A and C have same sign, but opposite to B. B is negative means A and C positive. B is positive means A and C is negative. So in case they will give the questions in the examination, you can take one example, then identify the answer. Okay. Next, if the quadratic equation ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, by observing the coefficients, the sum of the coefficient is, coefficient means a, b, c only now, sum of the coefficient is 0, then the roots are 1 and c by a. 1 and c by a. Remember it here. The sum of the coefficients are 1 and c by a. If a plus c is equal to b, or a minus b plus c is equal to 0, these condition is satisfied means we can identify directly roots. The roots are minus 1 and minus c by a. Okay, students? Next, the roots are in the ratio m is to n. That means alpha is to beta, that is equal to m is to n. That means, for suppose the roots are m alpha comma n alpha, these roots are in the ratio m is to n, or we can write alpha comma 2 alpha. These two roots are in the ratio 1 is to 2. Then what is the shortcut formula? This is the formula. M plus n whole square into AC, that is equal to mn b square. Or these mn send left hand side, AC send right hand side. M plus n whole square divided by n, mn is equal to b square by AC. Okay. Roots are in the ratio m is to n. Then this is the condition, shortcut formula. This is 1, 2, 3. Very, very important. Very, very important. These are shortcut formulas. Okay. Next. If one root is square of the other, that means one root is alpha, another root is alpha square. In this case, how to find relation between the roots and the coefficient? This is the formula. A square C plus C square A is equal to B into 3AC minus B square. One root is square of the other. So the roots are in the form of like this, alpha, alpha square. In this case, this is the shortcut formula. Here, how to identify ABC values, you know very well. A is X square coefficient, B is X coefficient, C is constant. Next, last formula, see this. If one root is equal to nth power of the other, that means one is alpha, another root is nth power, that is alpha power n. One is alpha, another one is nth power of the other, alpha, alpha power n. Then, how to do this? This is the shortcut formula. A c power n whole power 1 by n plus 1 plus A power n into c whole power 1 by n plus 1 plus b is equal to 0. Okay, one root is equal to nth power of the other. And sometimes they will give, if the roots are differ by particular constant, then b square minus 4ac is equal to a square k square. This is a shortcut formula. The roots are differ by k, then b square minus 4ac is equal to a square by k square. These are the important shortcut formulas. Okay, remember it. Then remaining concept, whatever is there, I will discuss in next class. Okay, thank you.